What I saw is that a religion of psychology has been established. Now, granted, I think this is mostly an online phenomenon, but it has its roots in a particular ideology that has become perhaps more intensified as a religious phenomenon over time, due to not being criticized. So there is actually, I believe, a underlying theoretical position, might be even one that's set in terms of the schooling of psychotherapists. There would be likely an academic aspect to it, or at least one that derives from academia somewhat and is yet formed in a way that appeals to what people are demanding from a religion nowadays. So the psychotherapeutic paradigm is now thoroughly religious, from all indications that I can tell, and that's how it is. And what that does is it creates a social force that is on the march on the basis of that particular religious ideology. Why is it religious? Because it has all the hallmarks of religion. It holds, for instance, that there is a life lesson to be learnt in humility. This is one of the strong hallmarks of a Christian position, in the sense of the typical expectation for Christians to have this particular characterological structure to them, that they should embrace humility. This is a really, really strong hallmark of the Christian ideology. So you can tell that it's there when you talk to people and you say, well, for me, it's not beneficial. For me, it's just so much navel-gazing. And then they look at you in a condescending way and they say, you just don't have enough humility. As if they could see into your heart. And I realize that even making this critique, it's already a disease that's gone too far. Already, it just looks like confirmation that there's just not enough humility there. It needs to be brought about in the realization of my being, that this is my destiny. I need to get lower into the sackcloth mode. I'm too arrogant. I'm too cheeky. I don't submit to what is fucking nonsense. And I need to be brought low so I can submit to it. This is the hallmark of a very aggressive religion disguised in the cloaks of a false humility. It's very, very false. It speaks a double language. It sort of speaks as if, well, you know, everybody can be okay so long as they admit their faults in humility. But actually, that's not really true. What it does is it actually continues to stigmatize, and even on a false basis. One fundamental false basis. I had a very happy childhood, ecstatically happy. And it's one of those, it is the fundamental thing that I can draw inspiration from, I can draw nourishment from. But according to the religion of psychology, my childhood was necessarily very oppressive. Necessarily, I must have had a very vulnerable childhood, because childhood as such is a very vulnerable time. And necessarily, the kind of life I live couldn't have done me any good at all, must have done me irreparable damage. Now, that's an ideological attack. That's a very insidious, very covert ideological attack on an upbringing that is not considered acceptable because it wasn't actually a specifically Western liberal upbringing. It's an ideological attack. It really is. And The whole mode of religious ideology is so pervasive that using normal language certainly doesn't suffice to make it back off, to make this religious ideology and its denizens have a second thought. Not yet, anyway, but the religion itself, it seems so liberatory, it seems so inviting. Just embrace your weakness and everybody will embrace you. But what we're doing is we're creating a generation of ninnies who are very happy and self-contented with their weakness.
We glorious servants with hearts full of war, fighting for a better world against the humans with their hearts of green loam. We glorious servants with hearts full of war, fighting for a better world against the humans with their hearts of green.